Hello, welcome to Cosplayers React to Miraculous Ladybug. This week we are doing a spooky special and we're watching Zombie Zoo. I'm Hilda Glitz.
I'm Rascal Rabbit.
And I'm Luminara.
Yeah! I love these little outfits, gang!
I'm obsessed, lads.
We are doing rubbishy versions of our superhero personas. So I'm a bee, duh.
I'm a cat, and I feel like Adrian would just rock up to a Halloween party dressed like this.
He does have that minus amount of brain cells required, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm a bug.
A little bug witch.
A little bug.
I like
bug.
That you moved your ribbons to be antennae. That's very cute.
Yeah.
Right, full disclosure, I've not seen this episode in about 3 years when it came out, so this is like a blind watch for me.
Let's go.
Oh, it's Miss Boosie's birthday!
It's her birthday!
Happy birthday!
Queen. Happy birthday,
Miss Boosie. I love that all of the kids get her presents and stuff because she's such a good teacher. Like,
she's such a queen.
She is such a queen. What is it with us and just sort of like seeing the kind of the adult women characters in this show and just being like, oh my god, I stan so much.
Because they're good! Queen.
What's like the female equivalent of like she's just a guy, you know what I mean?
Like, you're so right! What is the female equivalent of that? I just think she's neat.
I painted her as a superhero because—
That's really cute! What the heck?
Nathaniel did her a superhero Sona.
He sure did.
That's better.
Who is this Playmobil man? He looks like, you know when you go into a supermarket and you see knockoff, like, toys? He looks like knockoff Fred from Scooby-Doo.
Very specific, but that's very true. Yeah.
I'll give her a braid of hair to thank her for her breathing class. It helps me to be less afraid of Akumas.
Sorry, Mylene is giving Madame Bastia a braid of hair.
Hello, Madame Bastia. Here's my one
of
DNA. Her?
Here's a lock of hair.
I think we're really on the nose with the spooky Halloween episode because that's a bit haunted.
That's very haunted. Yeah, we're on haunted doll watch here.
Think of your emotions like the surface of a quiet lake.
Oh, Kim, honey.
Kim, bro. Same.
Morning, Chloe. Your hair is really pretty today.
What do you mean today?
My hair. Why is Chloe missing her sunglasses?
I was gonna say.
She looks naked without them.
See,
I would know
really
this because when I take my sunglasses off, it just looks so odd without anything on my head.
Also, do you reckon this is reused animation from Adrian playing piano? Like, no particular reason. I just.
Compared to those other gifts, mine's gonna be super lame.
Don't worry, Marinette.
Mylene's literally giving her a lock of hair.
Yeah, I think whatever you do, you're not coming in last here.
I'm also surprised that, you know, Marinette, her problem here isn't that she forgot the gift, it's that she did it, but sort of like...
But it's not good enough.
Yeah, because I assume that she would just sort of forget this kind of thing.
No, Marinette's quite good at remembering birthdays of people that she cares about.
Well, if she has their schedule on the wall, I guess.
Yeah, she doesn't have Madame Bustier's schedule on the wall, does she?
We wish to change the world. We must all learn to love each other. That's one of the first things Miss Bustier taught us when we first met her at school.
All right, Marinette, I don't want to hear any more about this present not being good enough. You've, like, remembered, like, a meaningful quote that, like, had an impact on your life. You handmade something. Literally step off. Yeah, Jivika's got the right idea.
I'm so lucky to get a teacher like her for my first year in school. How about you, Chloe? What's your present?
They're all really, really sucking up to Madame Bustier here, aren't they?
She's great when you remember that it is Adrian's first ever year of school.
First day at school.
Baby.
Him.
Anyway, all that stuff about compliments and love, ridiculous. Utterly ridiculous. This girl's got no heart.
Well, no, she's also got no family that love her properly, so...
She's also got extremely deep problems.
She's got extremely deep familial trauma, right? Leave her alone.
What's our next lesson again?
Physical science.
What's physical science?
Presumably physics.
Is that like him saying like just a regular word but in a sort of more scientific way?
Trying to be a bit fancy.
But like physical science just isn't a thing. That's not what physics is short for. I don't.
The incel physics versus the Chad physical science.
Well, isn't it short for like metaphysics, not like.
Yeah!
I don't know! But maybe it's just like chemistry, but they just like get up and run around the room sometimes.
I do have a present for you, Marinette Dupen Cheng.
Oh, Chloe, this is dastardly. I hate this.
I get it, but the present wasn't for Marinette. It was for Miss Bustier.
Yeah, so yeah, yeah.
The zinger doesn't really work.
Happy birthday, Miss Bustier.
Oh, you're also sweet.
Her freckles. She's so beautiful.
She's so happy.
A queen.
Marinette made that one.
What is...
Chloe, is this the best you could do? Like, I also just, it's so obvious that somebody else has tampered with this, like, because there is clearly a nice message written underneath.
Yeah, if she did, like, written on top, like, I hate you, Miss, she would have probably been confused. But
that's
like...
the thing, I feel like the reaction here is, okay, well, thank you. And then she'll pull Marinette aside after the class and go, can I just check that this is what you intended? And then Marinette would go, no. And then it
How
will...
are things at home, Marinette?
How are things at home? Are you okay?
It does just, like, if you didn't know that I'd been tampered with, it just sort of looks like someone who can't draw, doesn't it? Like, you're just...
Yeah.
Ah, very good.
I know you did this, Chloe Bourgeois.
Yeah, she did. She's not going to deny it.
She's not even denying it. She's just
like, yes.
Yes, and do it again.
A 99.56% certainty.
Max.
Is that his doing
Chloe calculator.
That girl is worse than Hawk Moth. At least half the city has gotten a...
Love, Alex is putting straight facts, so in fairness, she is the reason most of your compilations happen.
The classroom is not a place for insults and defamation.
It's not really defamation because it is true.
It is like... true. She's not even denying it. She's happy.
Yeah,
about
Chloe's
it.
Well chuffed. This is going exactly how she planned.
Can we appreciate Miss Bustier's little kitten heels as she wore to school?
I was
obsessed
gonna
with
say!
Them. Absolute style icon.
That feeling of injustice. What could be worse than being punished for someone else's wrongdoings?
I know that this isn't a Marinette akumatization episode, but it looks like it could have been.
It's very interesting because, like, this is quite late in the series and Marinette gets upset on the regular because she's obviously our protagonist, so she experiences, like, struggles, like, every day. So it's like, why is... was never picked up on it before?
Well, I was going to say, because we always thought that there was this thing that, like, the Ladybug and Cat Noir miraculouses, like, granted them kind of immunity, right? And obviously that isn't the case because Cat Blank happened, but it still felt like the Ladybug miraculous surely should act as some kind of protection, but nobody is safe from Hawk Moth.
I still stick with the theory that Adrian is so sad at such close range that it messes up the radar a little bit.
Who am I going to akumatize now? For goodness sake, Adrian.
Him training Natalie with the peacock miraculous. Like him sitting down and training her and being like, right, okay, you got to just block out Adrian a little bit. She's like, you mean he's sitting there, he's crying on with his piano. Like, do you want to just take the Hawk Moth suit off and just... And he's like, no, that's every day. Like,
that's every day, mate. That's his daily cry.
And evilize her.
Oh, he looks a bit naked without his, like, you know, his Shadow Moth getup. Yeah. I'm so used to season 4 now that he looks a little sad on his own.
And it's Koma. Oh, no. Go away.
She's so ready to defend.
There, the mere fear that harm...
What is this angle?
Fly, my little evil one, and akumatize
my little evil one.
Cute things to call your GM.
Cute things to call you, that my little evil one.
Don't give up. Think only positive thoughts.
Positive vibes only. Have you tried going for a walk and drinking some water?
I want to help you unite everyone together with love at last. Isn't that your greatest wish?
This is an interesting point, actually. The butterfly miraculous, right? It's not inherently a villainous miraculous because it's part of the same box as all of the ones that are used for good. And so I think it's interesting when you, like, think about the butterfly miraculous, if it was being used by a good guy, like, how would they use that for good rather than for evil? And I remember somebody ages ago, like, describing it as, like, creating champions rather than creating villains, which I think is really, it's a really cool idea. And I hope at some point in the series we get to see the butterfly miraculous used in, like, a good way.
Please breathe deeply and focus.
Marinette said, like, in for 10, out for 10.
In for 10, out for 10.
I really enjoy how, instead of going a couple of steps forward to, like, warn her classmates, she runs away.
Well, she's got to transform, though, hasn't she?
She does have to transform, in fairness.
Zombie Zoo, I'm giving you the power to spread love and compassion. Thanks to you, will be
Hold on. If he's still trying to convince her here, wouldn't Miss Bustier be like, right, why am I called Zombie Zoo? Because that doesn't really sound very love and compassion.
It's her being like, why is this my name? And him being like, I'm getting to that bit. Can you just like let me do my name?
Can you let me do my thing? Oh no.
Oh yes, queen.
God, I wish my lipstick would go on that smooth.
Oh my god.
This is a serve. Look at the fit.
I am obsessed with her.
What's this Sally Night Before Christmas vibe? Say, like... Look at Kim's face in the background.
The smoky eye, man. The like...
The heart lips, like the queen of heart. Yeah. Like, also, I like that she still looks like Miss Bustier, because I feel like there's been a few Akumas, especially in season four, like Rocketeer was one where it just felt like it was like, well, but that doesn't look like the person it was. And yeah. I know that sometimes that's the point, because, you know, if somebody gets like transformed into like a giant floating head, then obviously not really going to look like them. But I like that this is still her, but as like a zombie witch person.
Yeah.
From now on, everyone's going to hug and kiss and feel the love.
Ew.
The way you can hear Chloe go, ew. This is not suspicious at all. Miss Bustier steps outside with Marinette, and then Miss Bustier comes back in akumatized, and then Ladybug also walks back in. Just saying.
Interesting. Yeah, it's like, how do you know that she got akumatized? She's been inside the school the whole time. Were you inside the school, Ladybug? You're looking through the windows? Don't think so.
Suspect behavior. Sabrina.
Are you okay?
The way he can just lift her up like that. Damn, Ivan do be lifting though.
He's held.
I do love the like slightly gradual, like they're not instantly like, okay, villain time.
It's the zombie movie trope of them being bitten, well in this case kissed, and then there's like the incubation period.
Stop it, no, you're tickling me.
Why did Adrian stop to like, to have his like main character moment. Please put that gif of Big Bird like appearing in the door. The way she's kicking down the doors is killing me.
Right.
It's like that part of her Akuma power.
Yeah, I guess. Do you think it's like you get your main power and then you get like a little side power?
Yeah,
which is kicking doors.
Don't worry about it. Oh. She's not those ones off the hinges.
Just push open the door. None of these doors are locked. Just open.
It's the dramatics of it all.
There, that should hold you for a while.
I don't like that they're all sitting there going like this. That's horrible. I hate that.
Anybody here?
Speaking of zombie cliches, walking into a room where there might be a threat and going, hello?
Hello?
Anyone is just...
Ladybug!
Breaks her spine.
Suplexed by Ladybug.
Sorry, reflex.
Ladybug?
Yeah. Reflex! I know that she means like threat, but just the idea that her reflex reaction when she sees Chloe is just boof.
Adrian?
Oh, cringe.
I hate that. I like that unlike quite a lot of episodes, Adrian hasn't actually been kissed yet. He is just pretending to have been kissed so that he can be Cat Noir.
Credit where due. Brain. Man's shown a bit of evidence of life inside his little noggin today.
Well, but Adrian's probably quite familiar with this because he probably sits at home watching endless movies. And probably some of those were zombie movies. So he's got all the tropes in his brain. He's ready.
Come on, don't be ridiculous. How else will we work under the radar? Plague, claws out!
Oh, hi, guys. How else will we work under the radar?
Hey, everyone!
Claws out!
Strange diseases spreading.
Hey, guys, I'm all for our French greetings, but let's hold off on the kisses for now, huh?
I'm glad you...
I like that reference to it being specifically French greetings, because it's true. If you go to France, everyone just kisses each other on the cheeks. It's just what's done. which threw me a little bit when I was first at a French con, because the Brits don't do that. And so suddenly, like, everyone would be like, hello, and it would be random strangers and they'd be leaning in to kiss you on the cheek, which as a British person was a little bit alarming, but for the French, that's just completely normal.
Ladybug and Cat Noir, I'm coming for you. Mwah. Unless, of course, my sweetheart...
Heart mask as well.
It's cute.
The lens is ruined now. Always,
Chloe. You only think about yourself. I don't know why we don't. Alex was ready to sacrifice her. Alex was like, I say we push her.
Yeah. But it's like, in a zombie film, you'll have the, like, who do we throw overboard scene.
And you also have the person who's too aggressive and, like, you know, that fight. We mustn't fight amongst ourselves, guys. We need to stick together to survive.
But in this particular scene, there's no reason for them to do that. They're just being selfish. They're just like, you know what, Chloe, just get out of here. We're sick of you now.
Just give them what they want.
Yeah, good idea.
Is it my fault if I'm better than all of you?
I have missed some just blatant Chloe nonsense.
You can't discriminate against me for being better than you.
Cat Noir, do you know how to drive?
You should know the answer to that, m'lady. I can do anything.
But you can't drive.
Surely it should be no. He's a child.
Yeah, but she might not know this.
Oh, true, oh, true. Right, okay, one second, right, concept. Could you get done for, like, driving without a license if you're a superhero? Because obviously you can't carry a license around with you.
I don't think so. I think surely it comes under some kind of emergency legislation, right?
They probably had to draw up quite a lot of emergency legislation based on Ladybug and Cat Noir.
I feel like this is probably going to take a lot longer than Ladybug, who can swing from buildings.
Yeah, surely do it at the same time.
Yo-yoing something, picking someone up, going bonk, there you go, and going back real quick. Like, that's...
Play the hero as much as you like him, but you won't be getting a kiss out of me.
Just go before I change my mind.
Good for you, Kim.
Oh, Kim.
I forget that, like, Kim was obsessed with Chloe for a long time.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Slow down, Chloe!
She isn't...
Slow down! How? What do you mean?
Hello? Who's gonna come and save me?
In fairness, right? She's completely in the right there. She can't control the speed.
I can't just leave her by herself!
Oh, Rose. Oh, no.
Rose, no.
Okay, Rose.
Edge Rose, damn.
Rose been lifting.
She's lifting. What a
kissy. Not the ankle grab, no! Oh, I love this episode. It's so much fun.
Wow.
What is this? It went over the...
Oh, sorry, that finished me off.
Hurry up, we gotta go now.
Oh, no.
No, they got caught.
They got caught. Oh, look at that 3-point turn.
I was gonna say, Cat Noir's 3-point turn. That's good for someone who doesn't drive.
I thought you said you knew how to drive.
I've mastered every car and racetrack in Extreme Racing 3, but there are no buses in that game.
Oh, Adrian, bless him.
I can play Mario Kart. That's what you meant, right? Put the handbrake on.
Yeah, it does seem like he's got the handbrake on. Oh, no, Rose, you gotta tell them.
I mean, does she know, though? Like,
maybe she doesn't.
Well, because, like, with zombie films, like, if you get chomped on, you notice. But,
yeah,
like,
yeah, but sometimes you get chomped on and you deliberately keep it secret, because that happens in Shaun of the Dead.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But I feel like in this case, probably in all of the chaos, she got a little and didn't notice. And now she's like, I'm good. Let's go.
So what now?
Let's take Chloe to the top of the Eiffel Tower. There'll be less zombies up there and fewer places for-
And throw her off it.
I totally trust you, Ladybug!
Oh no!
People need to stop invading my personal space!
Queen.
Social distancing queen.
Nino! The vending machine! Quick!
She squished him.
She's just gonna.
Yeah, that could have been curtains.
I love this, like, the finale of this episode, because this is, again, classic zombie film. There's only like four of them left, and then they always end up in some, like, tall building with these like grills and stuff, because then you can have the zombies like shaking them.
Yeah, and I love that because it's that, but it's also so French because it's the Eiffel Tower, and like this is
what it looks like.
There's the Eiffel Tower, like.
Oh no!
No,
there's nothing we can do for her. Come on.
We can't save her now.
All right, she's dead. Just move on.
This is so sad. This scene makes me really genuinely sad.
Well, this is further proof that Adrian has just watched tons of zombie films. He knows what zombies are. Like, look, mate.
You can't do anything. If we bring her in the lift, we're all doomed. So we just leave her here. It's fine.
Nino?
I'm going to be here with my girl. Good for him, Tip's hat.
It doesn't matter that we're the only ones left. That
TikTok trend.
This cruel city.
Oh, guys, it's us! It's only us left!
Oh, no, survivors! Oh,
the final survivors. When the world is taken over by zombies, there will still be reacts.
Only the best remain.
True, Chloe. You speak the truth.
This isn't the first time we've been in trouble together.
Kisu.
Nina's like, if I'm gonna go, I'm gonna go with a smooch from my girl.
Ladybug, catch!
No!
The way she hauled him!
I'll just stay here and chill, m'lady. If we're going to end up kissing, then I'd rather do it after you save us, okay?
Oh!
You're the only one who can fix this for us. No arguing now!
It's down to you and me. Chloe? At least I won't get in your way now. Good luck.
Chloe!
Hand over Chloe and your miraculous ladybug.
I mean, right. What if she just says no and doesn't do Lucky Charm? I guess she can just kick the door down because she's good at that. But if she couldn't get in, what is then the process? What do you do?
Wait her out. She's got to come out sometime.
Yeah.
And then Ladybug's like, no, she's I can do this all day. There's no school because my teachers are traumatized. I'll just wait for you. Well, like, genuinely, I would love to see that happen in an episode where Ladybug's just like, you know what, I'm just not going to engage the Akuma and just see what happens.
Cataclysm!
Cat Noir!
No!
Don't worry, kitty, you'll get your kisses, but first,
that's a very bold promise to make when you have no intention of kissing him ever.
Sorry. What? This is all my fault. Awesome. But now's not exactly a good time.
Okay, the girl, cool. Anyway.
Oh my god.
An apology from Chloe Bourgeois. That is like gold dust, mate. You gotta take that. Like, she's done. She sounds genuinely sorry.
Save us all, Ladybug.
Chloe did a good thing.
She did. She's capable.
Good thing that wasn't like the Maybelline 24 hours super stay.
How did that hit with enough force to like remove?
Don't worry about it.
It just touched it. Damn. And that's the lip balm that Marinette gave her. Did she get it from like
cheap ass lip balm?
Unbelievable. Oh.
Beth, this could be us.
A little smooch.
The way they're just acting exactly the same.
If zombies always right, if love does always conquer, then someday my most cherished wish will come true for sure.
Bro, it's been like two seasons since and you still haven't done it. How are you feeling?
It's aging poorly for you, buddy.
Poorly aged things.
I let my name
negative emotions get the upper hand. How terrible. I'm terrible.
No, you're not. It's okay, Miss Bustier.
It's not okay, true. Queen.
It wasn't your fault.
Queen, lift your head. Your crown is slipping.
But I hurt a lot of people.
No. I did. I...
I'm proud of her.
I'm sorry, Miss Bustier.
Thank you, Chloe. Those words are the best possible gift you could ever give me.
I care her so much! Season 2. Season 2 was where the good Chloe content was at. This was when we had it good.
Stan.
Yeah. Okay then, we're all good.
That's the end of Chloe's self-awareness for today. Look at Kanoar, he's like, never seen anything like that before.
Didn't know she could do that.
Well, I heard you helped Ladybug and saved Miss Bustier. Awesome!
And where were you, Marinette?
Where were you?
Well, answer that. Don't worry about it.
Hopefully she'll learn if we continue setting a positive example.
Gee, I hope that that's what you continue to do for the rest of the season and series and not, like, bully her back. I'm not bitter.
Compliment to your neighbor.
Aww, Chloe did get her a present. I love this end screen. I love that little class photo. That looks exactly...
The girl's on there twice.
I was also going to say, that looks exactly like our group photo from school play. Like, even down to the placement. That was an excellent episode. I really enjoyed that.
Same, man.
I feel all spooky. I feel all ready for Halloween.
I feel ready for Halloween. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know in the comments what episodes you would like us to react to next. Make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any episodes. I hope you have a very spooky Halloween, and we will see you next time. Bye!
Bye!
Bye.
Hey you, the star I'm wishing on. Light up my world when things are wrong. Wanna tell you, but I tip over my words. I'm falling hard. Is love supposed to hurt? I tried to get over this crush. Under your spell, all I do is blush.
A final wiggle. A final wiggle.